why I asked Annie here, don't you?
Why?
You know.
Well, I got an idea, but what's the story?
I'm gonna ask her to marry me.
The girl is Larry's girl.
She's not Larry's girl.
And from Mother's point of view, Larry is not dead, and you have no right to take his girl. Now, you can go on from there if you know where to go, but I'm telling you, I don't know where to go. Well, look who's here. Georgie, good to see you. So how'd you find Dad? Feel all right?
No, he's not well, Joe.
Not his heart again, is it?
It's everything, Joe. It's his soul.
You wanted money, so I made money. Why must I be forgiven? There's nothing he could do that I wouldn't forgive, because he's my son. Because I'm his father and he's my son. Nothing's bigger than that. And if there's something bigger than that, I'll put a bullet in my head.
Thank you. Thank you. I was excited about the opportunity to direct All My Sons for Montana Rep because I believe so much in the play and the playwright. And I think the play has so much relevance today, not only the themes, but the meaning behind the themes, the struggle between father and son and community and individual and responsibility to society, and then the responsibility towards one's own personal honesty. Miller is very interested in structure, how a play unfolds, and that it not unfold too quickly or too radically or too emphatically in one place and therefore obscure another place. It's beautifully simple. In this play, it's an unwinding of the relationship. But for one thing said, but for one slight given, but for one thing not done, the whole thing comes unraveled. Obviously, one of the things that we want to make sure is that we're all in the same world in interpreting this play, so that we're sharing our ideas, the actors and I and the designers and everyone involved in the room we want to make sure that we're in the same world of this play. The most important sound of this play is the sound of the voice. And it's the music that's going to be made as Kate calls out through the kitchen window, as the little boy calls out over the fence, as Joe tells a story, as Chris and Anne speak to one another about their feelings for one another. That's the sound that's the most important. And what I will be trying to do is I want to try to hear first what the sound is that the actor hears. And that then we work together to explore what sound Miller was creating, how a sentence ends, what word he chooses to end a long speech with. That's the sound, and that's what's so important. My key word in that first rehearsal, and until we get audiences coming in, is it's going to be a time of exploration. Not only about the ideas that are in the play, but more importantly about the relationships. Miller, at that time, and we at this time, should be more concerned not with how the outward wrapping up of issues and things that are occurring, but what's at the base of them, what's inside the package. It feels to me that we're too concerned with the external and not concerned enough with the internal. And the internal is actually where our humanity is. It happens in the backyard, and there is no reason for it to happen anywhere else, because that's Joe's kingdom. That's where he rules. Sitting on the throne in his backyard, in his chairs, reading the paper, and the neighbors coming in almost as if they're coming to court to speak with the reigning head of the community. It's like a castle that keeps the world out and keeps the people in it in. That role of being the father has obscured Joe's role of being honest to himself. The honesty has to be to oneself before it can be to the community. And then likewise, it has to be to oneself in order that it can be responsibly so to the rest of society. None of these characters are doing anything except the best they can in the circumstances. One of the things that happens in this play is that Miller gets to celebrate what he thinks that all of us have as a responsibility as human beings, and that is to reflect on where we fit in humanity, on who we are, on what our responsibility is. How do we grapple with the constant change? All of that made me realize that this would be a challenge to direct because of the humanity in it and because of the themes within it, and then because of the universal power of a family, not bickering, but really in conflict, in trying to preserve their sensibility of who they are as a group and then who they are as individuals.
Probably one of the first images that I started with was this painting by Dean Mitchell called Midwest Mansion, and it's a painting of a mansion outside of Columbus, Ohio. The picture looks like this narrow sort of farmhouse, and you get the idea that it might be in the suburbs from these shadows off in the distance of other houses. And I really like that idea of like a farmhouse being surrounded by the suburbs. To me, the house really kind of takes on the personality of Joe. It stands in direct opposition to the ground. It's out there like some great big monolithic structure. You get this real sense of an iconic American home. That painting, Midwest Mansions, actually reminded me of other American artists like Edward Hopper and Andrew Wyeth. Andrew Wyeth's color palette really spoke to me, and Edward Hopper's sort of sense of the off-kilter and strong straight lines. There's a painting of his house by the railroad, and in the back you see this kind of almost kind of French chateau building, and in the front there's the raised line of the railroad that passes by the house, and it's very strong. The house is a little bit off kilter, and then the railroad in front comes in at a very low angle that kind of sets the whole thing off. The way that he sees the Midwest and American architecture and kind of paints them in a really modern perspective, and seems to be talking about what modernism is doing to the American past and how they're going through that transitional period. So then I took those images and started sketching, and I knew that it had to, I wanted it to land somewhere between abstract and real, kind of an amalgamation of the two. And I went through a lot of different sketches, some very abstract. We were seeing the show in a factory, and others very literal. I went through probably like 3 or 4, maybe even 5 different white models. But after some contemplation, Jerry asked me to try to escape a little bit further from all the realism. The fences were always present in all of my drawings from the very beginning. There was always the sense of the outside world of the yard and the inside world of the yard. The downstage portion kind of cuts across stage at this interesting diagonal that makes the whole set to me feel a little bit off kilter or exciting or some sort of element of conflict about the entire thing. The fence to me and in Joe's world holds his family in and keeps the outside world at bay. And then downstage front, I just wanted to slice the fence completely open so that, you know, so that we can actually see the actors. And because I think that somehow our gaze is brutal in that way, and kind of, I like that, like, that we're actually, this is somehow, I don't know why, but somehow a cruel act, or feels like we're doing something wrong by looking at this. An important element to the storytelling, or something that I think really serves the storytelling, are the three windows that are downstage. Through the kitchen window, I'm looking forward to seeing Kate move a lot. She kind of occupies this weird middle ground. But I would say that the set is largely realistic, but that at the edges it kind of becomes more abstract. The fence kind of starts to move in interesting abstract ways, and the walls of the house disintegrate at the top and to the sides. Jerry talked about seeing the play as kind of a boxing match, and I identify with that, with all these people popping in and out of the ring. So I wanted to incorporate this idea of the ethereal. Feels like this play is kind of elevated to that realm in some way. It's more than just a play about a family, it's a play about all of our families. What happens in this yard affects the rest of the world.
Thank you. Thank you.